What an incredible game. You've really outdone yourself, Activision. I never imagined gaining this much enjoyment from a simple video game. I mean, where do I even begin? Well, how about Call of Duty World War II's insanely fast loading screen? It's not like you have to wait for 10 minutes at various screens like the title screen or the black screen or a screen that tells you it's fetching your online profile. Nope, it's just one smooth transition to multiplayer. Well done. Oh boy, then we have headquarters. I've always wondered what a poor man's social space would look like. Thanks for showing me, Call of Duty. You mean to tell me there's loot crates here? Great! I was really getting tired of earning all of my guns, camo, and gear. What a lifesaver. Well, what about your classes and perk customization? Wait, there's no classes or perks? We have divisions and basic training? Oh wow! Wonderful! I really despise being able to have full control over the combination of weapons, attachments, and perks. The way Call of Duty World War II removed any intelligent way of combining these things is an absolute blast. It was totally unfair for me to have off the radar and a silencer. I mean, how else would my enemies know where I am? Skill? Psh, that's for noobs. And sheesh, there are a lot of new guns here. Absolutely none of them are the same from every other World War II game in the history of World War II games. None! MP40? STG-44 M1 Grand? The Bar? What are these new and exciting weapons? I wish I could give the developers a firm handshake on this one. Thank you. Thank you very much. Oh wow, and you've reduced the number of sidearms. I've always gotten so flustered when trying to pick the right one. Better just limit it to 3. Thanks, buddy. You know what? I just loathed having so many grenades and tactical equipment in previous Call of Duty games. It's really just best to choose one. I mean, I can't live long enough to throw 2 grenades and use tactical gear. Gosh. Excellent idea on the new lobby system. Not knowing who is on what team adds such a wonderful element of surprise to each round. And seeing everyone's avatar squatting and posturing like a new rap album really puts me in the 1940s setting. Wow, and don't get me even started on the great map design. Each map is absolutely massive, not tiny, no, not tiny at all. And there's dozens of routes to take and new little areas to explore. I never find myself running the same routes over and over and over and over and over. And thank you for making kill streaks just impossible to earn. I just hated having to take time out of my run and gunning to play around with badass bombers or gunners. Who wants to do that? Better that I just call in 1 or 2 recon planes a game. Oh, and speaking of recon planes, thanks for making them last about 10 seconds. We really don't want to have too much of an advantage now, do we? I'd also like to thank the person who OP'd the hell out of shotguns. It's quite literally my favorite way to die. Sure, I spent over a decade honing my ability to shoot medium and long range weapons, but it's really better that I just get killed by a charging noob with a shotgun who just started playing this last Christmas when his mom finally gave in and got him the game. I mean, fair is fair. Sometimes you just need to take a break from all this intense and exciting action. Well, thankfully, World War II builds this right in and forces you to spectate a teammate for up to 45 seconds. They even make it interesting and take away the graphics for the gun. It's really cute, and it promotes the realism depicted in this game. Oh, and emotes, yes! That's what we all wanted. I honestly didn't care about post-game stats anyway. I'd much rather see what goofy little hand gestures these shotgun-wielding noobs are gonna do. How fun! Speaking of stats, wow, just wow! The plethora of statistics and data are truly mind-numbing. I mean, look at the wealth of knowledge I can gain from examining the endless stream of information this game gives me. Truly, thank you, Call of Duty. Thank you. And all I'd have to say, the developers really worked hard on this one. You can tell they really care about their community, especially the longtime players who've been around since Call of Duty 4. The gameplay is so balanced and refreshing. It's totally not arcade-like, and it's entirely based off skill, not luck or your ability to purchase in-game currency. Nope. On Call of Duty World War II, skill is what matters most. From everyone here at Hungry Gaming, thank you for not wasting our $60. And we'll be right here for your next installment in November. Best wishes, the Master Hammer.